morning, Mrs Pumphrey.
Oh, thank you so much for coming.
Let's take a look at your Tricki.
Can you hear all that rasping and wheezing? It's like he's got a little steam train inside him. I asked Francois to build the fires up, but it hasn't made much difference.
It's not the cold.
Don't tell me it's the Spanish flu. I couldn't bear it.
I've never heard of that crossing over into the canine species before.
It's not a weak heart.
You've been sticking to the diet I prescribed.
To the letter, Mr. Herriot.
One cup of biscuits twice daily.
Perhaps not every letter. We all need the odd treat, or life becomes a little dull, don't you think?
Tricki Woo is becoming dangerously overweight. He's struggling to breathe.
He's going to die.
He's not going to die.
But he's been so listless, Mr. Herriot. I thought he must be suffering from malnutrition, so I've been giving him a little extra between meals just to build him up.
Did I ask?
A little calf's foot jelly, cod liver oil, beef Wellington, and a bowl of Horlicks at night just to help him sleep. Oh, dear. He's never been away from home before. Are you sure this is quite necessary?
Absolutely. We'll keep him at Skeldale House under observation. That way we can rule out anything more serious. What's all this?
Well, just a few essentials for Tricki. Can't have him going without. Oh, goodbye, my precious. Oh, this is too tragic.
I'll take good care of him. You have my word.